Okay, I'm gonna do another one from Rain's Blood. Rain's Blood, Ray's Blood. I say it so many different ways. I hope I got it right that time. Rain's Blood. English is my first language, I should know that. But anyway. Yeah, this one's movies. And I haven't done this one yet. It's quite a hard one to play acoustically. It's not really hard, but it's hard to kind of sing with it and then play with it, because everything's kind of like a one strum sort of thing, if you get me. Like the intro, it's kind of played through like a synthesizer. It's almost like that song from Muse, Blitz, or Blizz. Yeah, it's a Morgan Cemetery. Anyway, I'll get straight to this. You're going to need capo 3rd fret standard tuning. And you're gonna need lots of chords: E minor, B minor, C, A, B, G sharp, E, C sharp, a lot of those. If you can play the other song, you should be able to play this. So, yeah, okay. You're gonna start off an intro with an E minor. Then to a B minor. Then to a G. Back to an E minor, and then you're into your verse, which is the very same as that. So this is way too low for me. So then this is how it feels. Yeah, way too low. So yeah, that's there. So I'll just play the chords and you can figure it out. So this is how the verse goes, and I'll play it through the whole verse, but just the chords, won't sing with it, because you'll thank me. Someday you'll thank me why I shouldn't sing. Your chorus from there, so you can just fill in the words from there actually. So you're gonna need an E minor, but this is how it feels to be in love bit. So B minor, then G into an E minor. Box offices, I think. Then E minor. A to D. Then you're into your first chorus. I know I said I wouldn't sing, but there, I actually thought I was semi in key. Okay. So chorus one is, you go back, so you just go on to your chorus one now. So just scroll down my notes. Now, A minor. Kind of like all down strokes, like that. first two is slightly different to the first one, but it's very easy, so. Playing through it, but like the way I do it, I just kind of assume that you know the chords, and I just kind of play through it, like the where the chord changes and all that. And yeah, that's just the way I do it, anyway. So E minor to D to G back to E minor, so basically, same as the intro, except with words. So then you go into your second chorus. So then we play in C. Also low, very low. So you're gonna start with C to A minor to E minor. Start of it. They'll put me in a movie and everyone will know me, but I can't sing that bit. But you just start with a C. So, yeah, so about four strums of that. So basically your chorus, or not your chorus, but your bridge, it's just G, and all the meaning to C. So think of each chord changes when I know that I know a bit. So every I know, you change your chord. So G, and so I know. This meaning I see how the story. to G sharp minor, to E, to C sharp minor, and you just play that throughout the outro. So let me just see here. Good way to build up into this last bit is by going, so at the very end it goes like, I love movies. Too low and it's too high. It's just—it's a great song, though. That's one of the things. So, just at that bridge, what I was trying to explain there is when it goes like, I love movies, just kind of build up your strum into it, like going into the outro. So. Hopefully that's okay. So just repeat the outro of B to G sharp minor, B to C sharp minor, and finish on your B chord. And hopefully that's okay. Any questions, just leave them down. Yeah, I kind of rambled on a bit. I usually do this by now. You should know me. So try and do Mirror Forever as well. I have to learn that one yet. And if I can get that done, then that's all from the latest album. I'd be quite impressed with that, because I didn't actually know anything about Desertus until Andromeda, when I heard that. That was a great song. That was the first song I heard from her, so yeah. Keep that little anecdote for the end. I'll see you.